Hi everyone, here again with another SHAREfactory tutorial. This time we're going to talk probably about the biggest feature of 1.08, and that's the new Track 2 timeline. Previously commentary, this now allows you to save not only your video clips and your audio clips, but also add game clips to the commentary timeline, effectively making a second timeline. What you can do now, there's several different features that we're going to cover in this one. Some about the capture gallery, some about how to add filters, other things about how to apply green screen, as you'll find behind. Okay, so what are the main differences between Track 2 versus commentary? The main difference is that when we go in now, when you add a track, it's actually different between both modes, between both add Track 2 and edit Track 2. There are going to be different functionalities for each. Add Track 2 is simply for recording both audio and video and then adding clips. There's also two new options with the triangle button. One's camera mode and one's adjust mode. Camera mode is only for add mode. So you'll notice up here in the top, well, other side, the other side up here, it says add track two in the top corner. That'll actually be your identifier to tell you what mode you're in. Down at the bottom, you'll see the triangle button. If you go into that, that is capture or camera mode actually. Camera mode is allows you to set all of your background settings up, all of your recording settings. The difference between these two modes, camera mode is what you're going to record, what you're about to record. Set up all the presets of how you want your videos to actually be added into the Track 2 timeline, and then it will automatically apply these settings once you come in. So right now we're in normal mode, normal green screen behind us as normal. You go in and you hit X, and you can actually have your three options for normal recording, cutout recording, which will do a nice little circle cutout. You can actually edit in the different modes of, I want to change the radius, I want to change the feathering, I want to get it a nice sharp look, I want to give it, well, if I fix actual feathering, the sharp look, and then I want to change the radius. You can modify all of those settings right there. If you come back in there, let's say, the other thing people have been asking for very, very hard is pan and zoom. You zoom in with one stick and you can move it around however you need to. That'll be set up properly for any of your recordings that you actually need to do, so you can move it around and not adjust the camera for everything. It'll be a digital zoom, but it's still a zoom. That's the main thing. So let's go to the other cameras. Obviously green screen. It'll do an auto cutout with some automatic feathering, and it'll do the adjust mode. You'll notice up here where it says chroma key. That's the automatically selected color. So what it's doing is it's looking behind me and saying, what's the most primary color? Not even behind me, actually, it's just me in general. It'll look, pull off the camera what color it sees the most prevalent and actually cut that out. So if red becomes a more primary color, it's going to switch automatically to red based on whatever you have. If it goes and switches to blue, it's going to switch to blue cutout. This will all happen automatically. Now you lock these settings once you exit the mode. So if I exit out, it's locked to green. If I go back into camera mode and I switch it up here to blue, it automatically locks into blue. And so it's not actually cutting out green, it only cuts out once it sees blue, actually in the timeline. The other mode we actually have in the recording modes, we'll call this, or the camera modes, is white screen. So what white screen does, if you'll notice how silly I look right now because I'm so pale, it cuts out a contrast difference. So it's not gonna cut out black, but it's gonna cut out white. It's going to try to see, most people are gonna have a white wall, and that's what we're gonna try to cut out. It's not gonna be perfect probably, but it's going to help out for certain situations. So if you have something like a white shirt, it's gonna cut out that instead. And it's going to lock by the contrast mode, depending on your situation and whether or not you feel like you need this. So as we come back to normal mode, one thing we can talk about now is camera tuning. Camera tuning is something that's going to be a little more permanent than these other options. Most of these other options are just an application on top of the video that's saved. We'll come a little bit more into what I mean by this in a moment, but camera tuning is something that's going to affect the base video. So the sharpness, the contrast, the color hue, this is all going to be a kind of a permanent change, not for any recording that you do. You're going to see this, even if you add this clip into the main timeline, you're going to see this effect. Everything else is just going to have the normal green screen behind you. Now, you don't like this setting, you simply hit square and you reset it back to normal. Now, for this demonstration, let's go back to green screen real quick. As you notice, we're using the transparency grid behind us to show off that you're cutting out this color. You don't have to just stay with a transparent color. You can actually change the backdrop. So what this is going to do, and we're going to gloss over this real quickly because I'm probably going to go over this in more detail in another tutorial, but this is going to take you into the add screenshot screen. So you can pick anything that you have in your gallery. So we want to go by game, we'll say drive club, and we'll just grab the drive club backdrop. You can take any of your own screenshots and actually add that as a backdrop. Otherwise, you can take the new ShareFactory art. ShareFactory art is a few different options, and again, we're going to gloss over this real quick, but you can have all of these, most of these can be actually adjustable. So you have a solid color, a gradient, some animated ones like fire, cloud, and stars, and eclipse, and just have them thrown behind you actually to modify what you want your clip to look like. So what does all this mean actually? What does all these things mean if I can't actually record any more video than I have before? Well, that's kind of changed too. If you go into record and you say add clip, you'll notice that all of your commentary are now saving to the capture gallery, just like you would any other video game clip. So this means now you can add commentary freely, free of the 15-minute clip limit that we used to have for the budgets and everything. This still applies to audio because audio is still saved internally, but all of the commentary videos are now saving directly to the capture gallery so that they can actually be used at a later time. So you can freely record as much as you want to. So the primary thing to keep in mind when it comes to these recordings now is that it may not apply to video clips, but it does still apply to audio clips, meaning that you're going to have the same amount of data that you're going to use. So maybe about 6 to 7 hours of recorded commentary. Otherwise, you're going to have to delete that from your old projects to record more. But otherwise, video is going to be completely unrestricted. So I'm sure a few of you got a little twinkle in your eyes when you saw that I did add clip. One of the things that means now that Capture Gallery clips now contain the commentary is it means that it also contains the game clips. So I can pull any video game clip and pull that directly into the commentary timeline. So in effect, we have now side-by-side video. So I could go back to the normal timeline, add any clip that I want to from another game, let's say Resogun. And now I can have side-by-side video of two different games at the same time. So let's actually go back, so edit track 2, and we will say PIP layout of side-by-side. And look right there. So you can do side-by-side comparisons without any problem.
Multiplier up.
So that covers add track 2. So now what we can cover is edit track 2. Now the things that happened is that you're going to notice up here in the corner that it says add track 2, you're going to need to keep an eye on that because if you hit add or you hit X to record, that's going to invoke that. But if you highlight another commentary clip, let's skip back here to a previous one, and we hit edit, that's going to switch it to edit mode automatically. Now it's no longer showing a live video, it's only showing the clips that I have highlighted. So these are different ways you're going to be able to tell what modes you're in. And when you're in edit mode, you can actually go into adjust mode. So when you hit triangle, it actually pulls it into adjust mode instead of camera mode. So what are the differences here? This is, instead of adding or instead of setting the presets of what you're about to record, this now affects the clips that are already in the timeline. So you're changing the modes of what's already recorded. So you don't like this is a green screen. You want to switch it to cutout mode, and it'll switch it to cutout mode for anything in the timeline. And that also includes game clips. So you can actually apply green screen effects now to game clips you've added to the track 2 timeline. Let's keep this on green screen real quick and I'll show you a quick demonstration of this. So if I hit X to record, that switches to add mode as you notice up in the corner. Let's pick a slightly green video game like Resogun. And so as you notice, it's setting it in normal. You don't have any problem there. Switch over to edit. Now let's go in triangle adjust mode. This will switch. Now I can switch it to green screen. So it's kind of trying to cut out what green it knows is there. And as I seek along, you'll notice up in the top corner, it's trying to adjust to what color it thinks is most prevalent. That'll actually lock in once you exit this mode. So whatever clip you have highlighted, it's going to be adjusting based on the color that it sees most prevalently. And so it's going to lock that green in, and it's not going to be adjusting as you seek along. It's just going to be looking for that value of green to try to cut out. So that's something to keep in mind going forward, and I'll show you a couple tricks and then a few other tutorials that you can use this for. So what else can Edit Track 2 do? Well, you're going to still maintain all of your old normal motions, the move clip, to trim clip, to delete, and volume change for all your commentary clips, and your PIP layout. Now, there are a few changes to other options you can actually apply to these things now. The biggest one is probably going to be filters. So you can apply all the normal filters that you have in the actual normal timeline now to the basic ones that you want in your commentary. So you'll keep the green screens and it'll still be looking for all of that, but what's left in the video, you'll still apply all of the changes to for game whatever filter you want to actually use.
Effectively make it.
So you can also change the settings just as much as you would on any normal timeline. So this will add a lot of different things you can probably do with your videos. So one of the things you might have noticed already, even in this tutorial, is that now true full screen is something that you have an option for. And that is necessary if you're going to make it a full timeline. So you don't see anything if you make it full screen underneath to the actual, beneath the underlying video in track one. So you can change it to any of the normal modes. Now, most of these also have had some updates. So if you make it bottom right, it's going to give that flush look to the bottom corner of the screen, so you don't have that little space in between. Other changes will include stuff like side-by-side and layout, where as the clip starts, you'll notice that it animates in. So you'll come in and you'll have a side-by-side layout, and it'll slide
in with another SHAREfactory.
PIP layouts also include the new swivel layout that will slide the background video out and then slide in your PIP view. This time we're going to talk about. So what does this new PIP settings option do? Well, we've switched to center layout just to better show this off. You get now the options for a drop shadow, a frame, and you can change the color of the frame for each of your PIP layouts. So if you have a specific look that you would like to keep, you can select each of these with square, change the color picker to something, and we'll actually use a theme color here real quick, X, and apply it with X. And so now when you go back out, you're using the color as the ground of actually the clip. So now we'll talk about PIP backdrops. This option is generally going to be disabled unless you have two specific layouts used, and that's side-by-side and offset. So when you're in these two modes, you have the theme clip that's actually, or the theme art that's in the background to show off the clip as you're showing your PIP layout. What this option allows you to do is to change that background. So you can replace it with any of the SHAREfactory art, animated, or otherwise any of your own screenshots, and then you can come back to your main timeline, and now you have your own custom background on top of your two videos. So that should do it for this SHAREfactory tutorial on track two. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, or be sure to like and subscribe. Thanks again, guys.